19th Sunday of the year. Entrance antiphon. Look to your covenant, O Lord, and forget not the life of your poor ones forever. Arise, O God, and defend your cause, and not forget not the cries of those who seek you.
Look to your covenant, O Lord, and forget not the life of your poor ones forever. Arise, O God, and defend your cause, and forget not the cries of those who seek you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in the love of Christ, today we are in the 19th Sunday in ordinary time. Today's holy readings are inviting us to reflect on God's hand in our lives, especially in our struggles, in our difficulties, in our tough situations, even in the most crisis situations. The readings are giving us enormous assurance that God will take care of us, God will provide the timely blessings and graces for all of us. As the whole world is in the crisis of corona situation, let us ask the Lord in this Holy Eucharist to bless the entire world and the people, especially who are affected by the corona, and eradicate this pandemic. To participate in this Holy Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us acknowledge our failures and sins and receive pardon from our Lord. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
In the first reading, Elijah meets God not in a show of power and might, but in the gentle whispering of the breeze.
First reading, a reading from the first book of Kings. In those days, Elijah came to a cave and lodged in it. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him. And he said, "Go out and stand on the mount before the Lord." And behold, the Lord passed by. And a great and strong wind tore the mountains and broke in pieces the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, the sound of a low whisper. When Elijah heard it, he wrapped his face in his cloak and went out and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation.
I will hear what the Lord God speaks. He speaks of peace for his people and for his faithful. His salvation is near for those who fear him, and his glory will dwell in our land. Your response.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation.
Merciful love and faithfulness have met, justice and peace have kissed. Faithfulness shall spring from the earth, and justice look down from heaven. Your response.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation.
Also the Lord will bestow his bounty, and our earth shall yield its increase. Justice will march before him, and guide his steps on the way. Your response.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation.
Second reading. I read from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience bears me witness in the Holy Spirit that I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ. For the sake of my brothers, my kinsmen, according to the flesh, they are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the Lord, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from their race, according to the flesh, is the Christ, who is God over all, blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone, but the boat by this time was a long way from the land, beaten by the waves, for the wind was against them. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them walking on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified and said, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." And Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came to Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and took hold of him, saying to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased. And those in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, in our day-to-day lives, sometimes we do face tough situations, difficulties, painful moments, the very difficult situations. Whether we are lay people or religious people, we do face religious crisis, sometimes secular crisis. and sometimes spiritual crisis as well. And in today's first reading, we see Prophet Elijah undergoing the spiritual crisis. He is the man of God who defeated 450 false prophets of Baal God with the power of the Yahweh. And such a person is facing spiritual crisis in his own life. The first reading, first verse, if you see, Prophet Elijah is going to Mount Horeb. Why he went there? If you go through this previous paragraph in the Bible, there, in order to flee from Jezebel, the wife of Ahab, so the prophet in his own life, he faced such a situation. With the help of Yahweh, he performed many things, but still, in that time of, in his spiritual storm, he failed a little bit to trust in God. But the very important thing that we need to realize is that when he went and hid in that cave, what happened? The voice of Yahweh gave him enormous assurance to him. He heard the voice of Yahweh himself, and after that we know whatever happened. Everything, he went on to go on getting victories. And the gospel also connects very much with the first reading. As we have just read, Peter failed to put total trust in Jesus. It is his spiritual crisis. He wanted to walk on the water, but the faith, 100% faith, was not enough there for him. So in his life, this is also a storm, the spiritual storm. So my dear friends, at that time what happened? Jesus gave him providential hand to him to come up and to walk on the water. This shows that God will surely bless us whenever we are facing tough situations, difficult situation in our lifetimes, my dear friends. And at this situation, a very timely, inspirational story I would like to mention in my homily. Once, a parish priest, after the Sunday Mass, announced, "Since we are not having proper rains, we are going to pray for the rains. Therefore, we all need to go to the lake. We all need to go to the lake. We need to prepare food there, spend time there, pray there, and come." This is what the announcement was. Next week came, all of them reached the lake, and all the parents, elders, all were preparing food. They were very busy in preparing meals. And parish priest reached at the end. When he reached there, he saw a very beautiful sight, beautiful situation, a scene. What is that? One boy was carrying an umbrella, and father went near to him and asked, "My dear boy, all of your age children are playing around, your parents are cooking, but only you brought the umbrella and waiting for something. What is that?" he asked. Then that boy said, "Father, today we came here to pray for the rains, no? When we pray, surely God will send the rains, no? When we get rains, definitely we'll get wet, no? So I brought umbrella, Father," he told the boy, very small boy. What an inspirational answer that he gave the boy. Even the elders didn't have such a faith, but this small boy had that great faith in God that surely he will send the rain. This kind of faith you and me need to have, my dear friends. And in the readings, in a storm of spiritual crisis, Prophet Elijah failed and came back again. Peter, Saint Peter, also faced spiritual crisis and came back again to Jesus. And now it is our time. Now we also need to come back from our spiritual crisis in our own lives. Sometimes we may be neglecting to spend time with God because of the busy world situations, because of the busy schedule, because of the work that we have at home. And my dear friends, since in the gospel we have seen the storm, spiritual storm, and in the first thing also we have read spiritual storm, we also will be facing that spiritual storm in our personal lives, in our family lives, in our societal life. Personal life, if you see, the storm of ego maybe, the storm of anger, the storm of jealousy. And in a family life, the storm of relationship, where the relationships are breaking up. And in the societal life, there is no love for one another, which Jesus insisted upon the entire human world. Therefore, my dear friends, in number of ways, we will be facing the storms, the winds, the hurricanes, in different ways in our day-to-day lives. Therefore, in this Holy Eucharist, especially, let us place all our storms, winds, hurricanes that are coming in our personal life and in our family lives and in our societal lives, we put forward Him in this Holy Eucharist, so that the Lord who blessed Prophet Elijah, the Lord who blessed Saint Peter, also will bless all of us and give us His assurance in our day-to-day life. Amen. Let us profess our faith.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man for our sake. He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Often our expectations do not match with the reality. Elijah hopes to find God in the storm, in the earthquake, in the fire. But God is not in any of these, but in the soft sound of a gentle breeze. Let us now place our petition before God, saying, Lord, be gentle to us.
Lord, be gentle to us.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that in their ministry they may imitate Christ, who approaches the people gently yet firmly, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, be gentle to us.
For the people in public service, that they may serve the people with generosity of heart, so that people with grievances may approach them without fear, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, be gentle to us.
That Christians who follow Christ and are loved by God the Father may not deal rudely with a brother or sister who has done an offense, but may show forgiveness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, be gentle to us.
For those Christians who waver in their faith may have the courage to cry out to the Lord, who never abandons a sincere seeker, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, be gentle to us.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that enlightened by the word of God, we may live our lives in simplicity of heart for everything that creates of the spectacular passes away as it comes. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, be gentle to us.
God our Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus, whose absence from his disciples, even for a while, manifests their helplessness as they face the might of nature. Give us the grace that we may always remain close to the Lord, so as to draw strength and courage from him as we face difficulties and trials in our lives. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Oh, my.
pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, Jesus stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Holy Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this all off and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking in this holy Eucharistic Mass, we all may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Peter Machado our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, St. Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, found by divine teaching, let us all dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all our difficulties and sufferings in our personal life, in our family lives, and in our societal life, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you and my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the peace of Christ. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, who assures us his providence in our difficulties and sufferings. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come, at least spiritually, into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Come in an antiphon. The bread that I will give, says the Lord, is my flesh for the life of the world. Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'm rejoicing night and day as I walk the narrow way, for the hand of God in all my life I see. And the reason of my bliss, yes, the secret all is this, that the Comforter abides in me. He abides, he abides, he abides, he abides. Hallelujah, he abides in me. I'm rejoicing night and day as I walk the narrow way, for the Comforter abides in me.